Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn Algebra Standard 9th. Second lesson, Real Numbers Practice Set 2.3. In the last session, you have learned question number 1 to 5. Today, let's learn question number 6. Before starting question number 6, let's recall irrational numbers and surds. Irrational numbers are the numbers which cannot be expressed in the form of p upon q, where p and q are integers. In simple language, non-perfect squares and non-terminating and non-recurring decimals are called as irrational numbers. Now children, let's learn definition of surd. Surds are the irrational numbers which are roots of positive integers and the value of a roots cannot be determined. Children, surds means irrational numbers. Irrational numbers and surds both are same. For better understanding, let's see one more definition from your 9th standard textbook. If n is a natural number, a is a positive rational number, and nth root of a is an irrational number, then nth root of a is called a surd. In the surd, nth root of a means a is a radicand, n is the order of the surd, and the square root symbol is known as radical sign. Children, here are the some rules to recognize a surd. N is a natural number greater than 1. It means the order of the surd should always greater than 1. A is a positive rational number. If children, nth root of A is a irrational number, then only we called as surd. Now, practice set 2.3, question number 6, simplify. First one, 5 root 3 plus 8 root 3. For adding the surds, we want the radicand should be same. Here the radicand is same, root 3 and root 3. So we can add the coefficients equal to 5 plus 8 root 3. 5 and 8 are the coefficients. So we can add when radicand is same. Equal to 13 root 3. 5 plus 8 is 13 and root 3. Now question number 2. 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus root 125. Here under root 5 is there 5, but in the third term, root 125. So 125 you have to split equal to 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus root 25 into 5. 25 is a perfect square. So it will come out, it become 5. Equal to 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus 5 root 5. Take all the coefficient in the one bracket. 9 minus 4 plus 5 and take the root 5 common. So 9 minus 4 plus 5, you get children 10 root 5. Now question number 3. 7 root 48 minus root 27 minus root 3. Children, here all the digits under root are different. We have to make it equal. So 48 you split into children, 16 threes are 48, 27 9 threes are 27. So 7 into root 16 into root 3 minus root 9 into root 3 minus root 3. 16 is a perfect square and 9 is also perfect square. So it will come out of the root. 7 into 4 root 3 minus 3 root 3 minus 3. Take all the coefficient together and root 3 take the common. 7 into 4 you get 28. root 3 minus 3 minus root 3. Now 28 minus 3 and minus 1. Here the coefficient nothing is there with the third term, but we have to take 1. Now 28 minus 3, it become 25 minus 1, you get 24 root 3. Now children, question number 7. Multiply and write the answer in the simplest form. We have to simplify this question. 12 under root is there children. We can split that 12 4 3s are. 18 9 2s are. So 3 into root 4 into root 3 into root 9 into root 2. 4 is a perfect square, it become 2. 9 is a perfect square, it become 3. 3 into 2 into 3 into root 3 into root 2. All the coefficient take together and root numbers take together. 3 2s are 6, 6 3s are 18. 18 and under root, what the numbers are there? 3 into 2. So 3 2s are 6. Now question number 2. 3 into root 12 into 7 into root 15. 12 we have to split into 4 3s and 15 you have to split into 3 5s. 3 into root 4 into root 3 into 7 into root 5 into root 3. Now 4 is a perfect square, it comes out, it becomes 2. So 3 into 2 into 7 into root 3 into root 3 into root 5. Root 3 into root 3, it become 9. So 9 is a perfect square. So it comes out, it become 3. Now 3 into 2 into 7 into 3 into root 5. It become 126 root 5. Now question number 3. Root 8 into root 5. 8 we can split into 4 2s are 8. So 3 into root 4 into root 2 into root 5. Root 5 we can't split children, so keep as it is. Now 4 is a perfect square, so it comes out, it become 2. So 3 into 2 into root 2 into root 5. 3 2s are 6. Root 2 into root 5, it become root 10. Now children, question number 4. 5 root 8 into 2 root 8. Here children, 8 not to split because root 8 into root 8, it becomes 64. So 64 is the perfect square, it will come out, it become 8. 5 into root 8 into 2 into root 8. Here children, coefficient take together. 5 into 2 into root 8 into root 8. Root 8 into root 8, 64. So 64 is a children perfect square. Now children, multiply coefficient. 5 2s are 10 into root 8 into root 8, 64. It become 8. So 10 into 8, it become 80. Now children, let's see question number 8. Divide and write the answer in the simplest form. First one children, root 98 divided by root 2. So we have to divide children 98 by 2. Root 98 upon root 2. That slash is the division sign children upon. Here we have to divide children 98 upon 2. So 2 4s are 8. 1 will carry, 2 9s are 18. So root 49 equal to 7. Now question number 2. Root 125 divided by root 50. We have to, children, divide simple division how you used to do. So, root 125 upon root 50. 25 2s are 50, 25 5s are 125. Equal to root 5 upon root 2. Now, question number 3. Root 54 divided by root 27. Children, simple division, 54 upon 27 you take. 27 ones are, 27 twos are 54. Equal to root 54 upon root 27. So, you get under root 2. Now, children, question number 4. Root 310 divided by root 5. Simple division, children. You have to take upon in the fraction and you do the cancellation. Root 310 divided by root 5. Now 5 ones are 5, 6 are 30, 1 will carry, 5 twos are 10. So under root 62 is your answer, children. In the next video, children, we will learn how to rationalize the denominator. Thanks, dear students. Have a great day.